Minimalism is all about having one color. Minimalism means having nothing. A minimalist doesn't buy anything. You know, I don't blame anyone to have these thoughts in their head because we always use those extreme examples as a representation of minimalism. And for someone who always talk about minimalism on YouTube, I feel that it's my obligation to clarify some of this myth about minimalism and debunk some of this misconception today. So the first, let us start with, all minimalist is eco-friendly. That's one of the main misconceptions I had before I become a minimalist. Thinking that being a minimalist means automatically comes in a bundle of free, being eco-friendly, and being a vegan, or any stereotypes about being a minimalist. And oftentimes, people got mixed up between minimalism and being eco-friendly. And I guess it's because the way we live our life, both of them is pretty similar in terms of living with less, but it differs in the purpose and why we are doing it and the way we are doing it. So it doesn't mean that we need to be a minimalist to be eco-friendly and vice versa. Minimalism is the answer to all questions. Let's look at minimalism as a tool. Let's say a power drill is useful to drill a hole and screw in and out a screw. But if you need to paint your room, hammer a nail, wash your dishes, then a power tool is definitely not the best tool for these jobs. Similarly, minimalism might help you with one area of your life, but it doesn't mean that it's the answer to all questions. I mean, if it fits your lifestyle, then that's great. But by thinking that minimalism is the solution to everything, we might fall for a trap of applying minimalism to every single thing in our life, even if it doesn't benefit us, or even worse, we might forcefully apply it in other people's life as well. So let me go back to the analogy of using a tool. A power drill is good for screwing, but there are other ways like using a screwdriver or even a coin, and all of them can get the job done. So if your preference is to use a power drill, then good for you. But we shouldn't assume that it's a one-size-fits-all solution for everyone or every single problem. And that brings us to the next point. If you are a minimalist, everything has to be minimal. I'm sure you heard of this Greek mythology where the king was granted his wish. Everything he touched will turn into gold. What seems like a gift turned out to be the worst curse ever because he can't eat or drink as all of his food is transformed into gold. He even accidentally transformed his daughter into gold. And I think this king's ability is pretty similar to one having the knowledge of minimalism. No matter how much we enjoy minimalism, we wouldn't want whatever we touch turn into a minimalistic version of it. I think it's wrong to assume that every area of a minimalist life has to be minimal. It's a weird, redundant stress of being a minimalist. And it comes externally from how people judge others and internally from our own expectation of minimalism that is causing us this stress. And that's an issue I realized recently in my minimalism journey. Applying minimalism to every single aspect of my life, even if it doesn't benefit me. Minimalist bedroom, minimalist wardrobe, minimalist friendship, minimalist work life, minimalist phone, minimalist social media, minimalist wallet, minimalist finance, minimalist everything. This list goes on. And I think there shouldn't be a need for us to make everything minimal just so we can uphold the image of a minimalist. If you like tons of books and appreciate owning a collection, it's fine not to have a minimalist book collection just because you are a minimalist. Just like the previous point, use it as a tool. And of course, there's nothing wrong with applying minimalism to every single thing as long as it works for you and not because you're obsessed with it. Minimalists have no style. I guess the fact that rejecting trends and consumerism gave birth to this myth. At first, I didn't really want to touch on this topic because I think it's really subjective. As a minimalist, I still need to clarify this. I'm not going to prove the opposite by showing you a list of minimalists who understand aesthetics. But what I'm trying to say here is there will definitely be different types of people out there. Minimalists who understand style, minimalists who has no style, a designer who don't know how to dress, an accountant who dress well. And all of this opinion is subjective. Anyone can be a minimalist with good sense of style. At the same time, another minimalist can have zero sense of style because it's not something he or she cares about. And you know, either way, both of them are living their life intentionally based on their own value, which is what matters. Minimalist lifestyle is boring. Like I said from the start, what often stuck in our mind is always the extremes. We only remember the person who declutters everything, the person who has a uniform, the person who can fit everything in his backpack. And it doesn't mean all minimalists follow the same lifestyle. Whether a lifestyle is boring or not depends on the person living it. And what seems boring to you might be something intentional to someone else. For example, having a uniform can be boring to you, but it might not be boring to someone who enjoys what he or she wears every day. Not to mention, it's intentionally created to be consistent, just so they don't spend too much time and thoughts thinking about what to wear. If this method doesn't fit you, you can always be creative to change it yourself. For example, having a capsule wardrobe. Having a sufficient number of clothes while still having ways to be creative with your outfit. So, minimalism is boring if you want it to be boring. Minimalism rejects new purchase. You know, I still enjoy shopping and research on the things that I want to buy and also appreciate the benefits I receive from a new product. I still enjoy the dopamine rush of buying something new. And we just have to accept that minimalists are still human and there's no point rejecting human emotions. But of course, if you are still currently experiencing a compulsive buying habit or buying things for the rush, then yes, it's needed for you to have that limitation on your behavior to change for the better. But if you don't have this issue, I think being a minimalist doesn't mean suppressing your desire, but it's to understand the reason why you want something. And if that particular item will bring you value and the action of buying aligns with your goals, especially for your finance, then I think there's nothing wrong to do that. Question: if a minimalist who is interested in a particular luxury brand, should he or she deprive themselves from getting the particular item just because they are a minimalist? I think that can be a video by itself. But for now, we can always consider minimalism as an extra filter before we consider whether we want to buy a certain product. Being a minimalist means you can only own X amount of things. I think this misconception comes from different title, headline, from blog posts and videos. I understand that might be misleading. But I guess it's fine because it's also this headline and title that is attracting people to dive deep into minimalism. And I'm pretty sure it's not the creator's intention to show off or to tell others that their way of minimalism is the real minimalism. So just take it with a pinch of salt and find your own path to your own minimalism. And remember, numbers don't play a big role in minimalism. They are just a guidepost. Minimalism is the new poor. Or some might see it as, minimalism is something only the rich can buy. Both myths are contradicting. But it's actually the two sides of the same coin. I made a video about this last year, about the connection between money, frugality, and minimalism. But either which is just a myth because it depends on how you see minimalism and the reason why you adopt this kind of lifestyle. I find minimalism appealing to me because I was struggling to pay off my debt and I want it gone as soon as possible. And this sudden realization and discovery of minimalism came in at the right time, where it aligns with what I wanted to achieve. And of course, throughout the journey, I also discovered different ways it can benefit me in different areas. However, if you look at other people's journey, where minimalism to them is buying quality stuff instead of quantity, pursuing the minimalistic aesthetic where negative space is needed to enhance the beauty. To many, they might seem like a lifestyle for the rich, and some minimalistic aesthetics aren't affordable, for example, space. I mean, you can look at Kanye West's house and you would know. But why do I say it's two sides of the same coin? Because it depends on our perspective on minimalism and what it means to us. Just because you see it on the right side doesn't mean it can't be executed from the left side. It's not a one-way lane. And now, let me have a quick message and thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes for lifelong learners like you. They have classes ranging from entrepreneurship to creative skills like animation and photography. You know, no matter where I am in life, there's always something I can learn and develop new skill from Skillshare. I'm always trying new ways to film and present my video through cinematography and storytelling classes. If you're interested in upgrading your skills, Skillshare is offering 1,000 of you a free trial for their premium membership, and that gives you access to all their classes. After the end of the trial, the annual subscription fee costs less than $10 every month. And that's considered affordable considering the amount of value you'll receive from those classes. And I'm sure you can make the full use out of this and apply those skills into your life. So that's the 8 myths about minimalism I want to debunk. Of course, there are other misconceptions which I always mention. For example, minimalism is all about having nothing, or you have to follow rules to become a minimalist. I'm pretty sure you have some in your mind, so share it with us down in the comment section. If you enjoyed watching this, a friendly click on the like button will help a lot with the channel's algorithm. So I appreciate the love. And I don't know when's the next time YouTube will push my video to you guys. So if you are new here, you might want to consider subscribing to this channel and also on the bell icon for future video. I really appreciate that. Thanks for watching this, and I'll see you guys again on the next.